Hey everyone, it's Justin again. For the rest of this unit, we're going to be looking at all the different characteristics that make functions function. Pun very intended. The first few characteristics, domain and range, are very important because they help decide what is or is not a proper function. Most of this video will focus on graphed functions, but first, let's define a few terms. Domain and range. The domain of a function is all of the inputs, or x values, that are related to a possible output from the function. Think about the vending machine again. You can't just put in 2 pennies and expect a snack. Since 2 cents doesn't get you anything, it wouldn't be in the domain of the vending machine. The range, on the other hand, is all of the possible outputs, or f of x or y values, that can be obtained by using some input. If a vending machine sells candy bars, you can't get a burger out of it, no matter how much money you put in. So burgers would not be in the range of items available from the vending machine. These ideas are easier to understand visually, so let's look at some graphs. Remember, for functions, the inputs are found along the horizontal axis, and the outputs are found along the vertical axis. Here we have a discrete function. The domain is all the inputs that have an output. Every point has an input connected to an output, so to find the domain, we just list all the inputs where a point exists. There are points at -4, -1, 0, 2, and 5 on this graph. So that list of values is the domain. See how there's a lot of missing numbers missing from the list? It's because they have no point. 3 is not in the domain because without a point, we can't connect it to a particular output. Range is very similar, but focused on the output instead of the input. So for the range, we have -3, 0, 2, and 4. Each of those outputs has a connected input. For instance, an input of 5 gives an output of 2, so 2 is in the function's range. -2, though, is not, because none of the inputs have a point there. But as we all know, not all graphs are discrete. Let's find the domain and range of a similar graph, but continuous. For the domain, we need to list every input that has a point, but the entire curve is made of points. 1 has a point, and 2 has a point, but so does 1.5, and 1.25, and 1.17, and 1.1935, it would take forever, literally, to list the input for every one of these points. So is there a better way to describe the domain? Of course there is. Instead of individual values, we can just list the interval that all the points are on. For this graph, the graph begins at -5 and continues to the right forever, never stopping, as we can see from this arrow. How would we write that the value can be -5 or anything higher? We've done this before. An inequality. We would write this inequality as x greater than or equal to -5, which just means the inputs can be any value at or to the right of -5. For the range, the process is going to be exactly the same. The lowest value is at exactly -2, and the graph goes up forever, thanks to the arrow. So we'd say that the range is at every value at or above -2. This way, we don't have to list every single number between -5 and infinity for the domain, or between -2 and infinity for the range. However, even with continuous functions, sometimes values get skipped over. Take this function, for instance. We see that this function has empty points, or holes, in a couple of places. These holes are basically non-points, places on the function where the point that's supposed to be there is missing. The problem is, if there's no point, then it can't be included in the domain or range. So how do we write intervals if points are missing? Here's the domain for this function. It includes all values to the left of negative 2, but there is not a point at exactly negative 2. So the inequality does not include or equal to. But that's not all of the inputs. There are also inputs in this area. This section passes through every input between negative 2 and 2, but those values themselves are empty. So again, we're going to use strict inequalities rather than or equal to. For the range, we work from the bottom up, being careful only to include outputs where there's a point. So what do you think the first section will be? If you said the outputs are between negative 2 and negative 1, you'd be wrong. Take a closer look at the output of negative 1. While there is one missing point, there are still two other points with that output, which means it's included in the range. So what's really the first section of the range? Well, it starts at exactly negative 2 and goes up and up and up until 2. 2 is the first output we see that has no points at all. So the first section of the range is actually between negative 2 and 2. We use the or equal to for the negative 2 because there is a point there right at the bottom of the big drop. But that's not all the outputs though. There are more outputs above 2 going up forever. So we have a second interval of all values greater than 2. Domain and range can be tricky concepts, but the key points to understand are the domain is all the inputs with a point. The range is all the outputs with points. For continuous graphs, use inequality intervals instead of a list. And remember to skip over any inputs or outputs that don't have any points. If you need some practice with domain and range, try out the practice game on our website. You want to have a good understanding of domain and range before moving on, because in the next video, we'll be putting away the graphs and learning how to calculate domains of functions algebraically. See you then.